Hello folks, so let's start a pre-video for solving the problem. And I'm just going to repeat my five-step process to apply in every problem solution on LeetCode so that these will make sure that day by day your intuition for pattern finding or solving a problem or building your intuitional logic, these all are getting supported by your effort. So because my video is not about how to solve the problem only, it is also about how to think, how to intuitively derive your logic. Because being an experienced engineer or being a beginner engineer, most of the time we are actually getting getting carried away from our fundamental requirement. Because we are seeing the other solution, other's video, and we are getting fascinated. I mean, we all are quickly getting attracted with some other's approach, right? And we start thinking that way, but that is not exactly a requirement of yours, right? Our requirement is how to create my own thinking system. Once I start thinking in that way, probably that will help us to crack any new problem. Because interview or any, like becoming a skilled engineer, it's not like solving some LeetCode problem or few LeetCode problem. It is all about whenever you are getting any coding problem or any problem which need to be implemented, my intuition or thought process will start working for that problem. And then we will, even though the challenge is new to me, we will start going step by step, and then eventually we will open that thought which will solve that problem, right? That is what we should do. And that's why I'm saying that you should always follow five-step process. And that first step is understand problem, example, and constraint. Okay, this is the step one. Clearly understand the problem, example, and constraints. Step two, very critical, approach finalization with time and space complexity analysis. This is very much required step, and I would like to emphasize here that you should always try to think on your way. Don't see anybody's video until you decide your own approach. Because if you start seeing others' approach, then you will once you see it, the approach, you will feel comfortable. Okay, I have done it. But then eventually you forget very quickly. I mean, after 1 week even, you can't remember what you did. So that's why my always, even for myself, this is my concern also. And I have to improve in this area, that how I can retain my intuition, how I can retain my fundamental way to approach the problem. And one thing is retaining, another thing is day by day improvement, right? So if I'm able to improve myself in this intuition logical approach for solving a problem, and I will improve day by day, definitely it will add value to me. And then this effort even makes sense to you, right? So that's why try to finalize your own approach first, and then see others' approach, like how it is different, where you are lacking or where you are doing better than this others' approach, like that way. Then compare it, and then try to understand where you have your own understanding and what are the gap you are seeing there, right? So these kind of things you should do. Step three is implement your approach and try to submit your before proceeding to submit, I request you to form your own test cases to check your solution. Okay, so form your own. This is very fundamentally very good step. Otherwise, you have seen that many times when you're submitting, then there are sometimes like integer overflow or sometimes time complexity. I mean, you are taking lots of time. So your TLE kind of things, error, TLE, maybe sometimes exception thrown because of nulls or null division or anything like that, or null pointer. So these kinds of these are the things you should you can avoid if you can write your own test cases. And then you should run the test on your implementation first before submitting to the evaluation of your solution, right? So that's why step three is very important, very crucial step here. I would say very crucial. Okay, so this is your step three. Let's go to the step four process. Now, step four. step four. Step four is here. Step four is just try to make. Now, submit your code for evaluation, and see the gap. If you are finding any gap in your understanding, go back to implementation, correct it, and also add this failure in your test case. Also, make note of missing this case in your implementation. So this that is the fourth step. And the fifth step, which is step five, and this is saying that you should always think on step five, which is very crucial. And that's why I'm marking with some pink or red kind of things, that compare your solution with others' solution, especially if their time and space complexity is better than yours. So this is very super confidence, important step. And I would say please definitely do this step, because this is the one step which will help you to improve in your analysis, in your observation, in your intuition, in your logic building. So all these things are improved if you compare other solution with your solution, and then you will see that what kind of gap you are finding in the solutions. Like how they found that thing in their approach, why they are considering this. And these will eventually form the pattern for you, right? And so these are the only things which you need to improve your logical thought process. So hit on the logical thought process exactly where you required. By this much saying, I'm just wrapping this video because someone have asked me to help me, to help in this step, like why these five steps is important for problem solving. Because problem solving is time-bounded, right? If you do it, if you follow this, theoretically, then you definitely require more time to finish that one problem. So, what would be the best approach? Are following these five steps? So my answer to this question is very simple, that maybe initially you may lead some higher time. You feel that these are the required steps. That's why you have to follow one by one. But eventually, if you make it practice in every problem, then this would be, you start seeing that this is not going to add any extra time. In fact, it is helping you to identify the corner cases quickly, right? And that will make more sense to you when you are solving the hard problem, especially the complex kind of problem. Okay, thank you. Thanks for your patience. And I'm hoping your consistent attachment with this channel. And I love you to all your support, whatever you are giving to this channel. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Bye. Take care.